Hello everyone, I hope everyone is doing fantastic. Today we'll start a topic which is of utmost importance to every single person who is a part of hospitality industry. This topic is not just related to one set of hotels, but to every single person who normally works in a hospitality industry, someone who faces a customer. Look at the topic here. The name of the topic is guest complaints. Yes, you read it right. It's guest complaints. All those guests who turns up with you and do a complaint, we'll talk about them. We'll talk about this topic here. Now, in this topic, we'll talk about the various types of complaint which one has it, a grudge which is being communicated over to the front desk team members. All those set of complaints, we'll talk about it. And importantly, how do we resolve that complaint? When someone brings a complaint over to the front desk people, now being a manager or being a supervisor, what action do we take? How do we resolve that complaint? That is something which is very, very important. Now, by end of the topic, the main learning objective of this topic is that one should get to know that why a concern is being raised, why someone is raising a concern. This could be due to any of a problem, any of a grudge, any of a service which is being not accomplished, not being fulfilled, not being promised by the hotel member. Someone has a problem about it. Why the problem is there? Now, being an employee, we should know that how can we make that customer happy? How do we overcome that complaint? That is very, very important. Being a supervisor or being a manager, that is something which is being taught to a person right from day one. The moment someone comes over to you, someone tells you, look, boss, this is something which went bad with me. This is something which I didn't like about your hotel. This is something which is being fed into the employee, that how do we need to interact with the employees and resolve that customer. Because we, being an employee who work in the industry, we only have one motto, and that is we need to bring a smile on the customer's face. That is something which is very, very important. To start with the topic, we'll talk about the guest complaints first. Why someone has a complaint? Why someone has a complaint? Why someone has an issue about it? Now, if you talk about it, why about it? Whenever customers, they are not satisfied with any of the services which is being provided by us, they have a grudge inside it that yes, I paid 10,000 rupees for just a room night stay, but those promises which were being given to me by the hotel team members, or maybe your website says, or maybe your reservation confirmation says about it, whenever those things are not being fulfilled, those grudges, those concerns are being transformed into a guest complaint. And again, whenever customers come up with you, they put you that concerns, that is what we call it a guest complaint. Now, important part is, what are those various concerns which one has it and which tells us over? I would like to describe it with images, with graphics. Please look at it yourself. Now, look at the first picture. The girl here is working in a reservation team. There could be a possibility, there could be a complaint related to someone's flight, someone's wrong room rate. Maybe the room is being booked on a bad date, or on a wrong date, sorry. And importantly, someone has requested about a flight pickup, or maybe from a morning flight. And she is by mistake entered into other's profile, or maybe she has entered into a wrong date, or maybe a wrong set of flight. So the car is not being sent. So that problem, that concern is turned into a guest complaint when someone will not find a car during his arrival at the airport. Look at the second picture. It shows about a hotel is sold out. Someone who has reserved a booking, someone who has even got a confirmation, but whenever someone turns up at the hotel officials, the receptionist tells him, sorry sir, we don't have rooms available. The hotel is sold out. That is again one of the major challenges which hotel industry is working on. Third one, as the picture says, the person is complaining about the food. Now there could be a possibility he ordered something else and he got something else, or maybe the food is not as per his expectation. So this is again termed as a complaint. Next picture, look at the first one here. Now there could be a possibility that person requested cleaning of a room. Maybe he or she passed on a message maybe to the front office team or maybe to the housekeeping team to clean the room, but due to maybe any of the misunderstanding or any of the confusion or any of the problems, or they could have skipped the service, but the resulting in that the customer didn't got his room clean, it will turn into a guest complaint. Look at the second and third picture. This is something which is a major challenge which every single hotel is working as if now. On the second picture, it shows that the moment you put in the electronic key card to open a hotel door lock, There could be a possibility that the electronic key card gets demagnetized because hotel officials quite often tell us that, please, sir, ma'am, please do not keep your key card neither with any of the electronic gadgets, devices, nor with a credit card, because the electronic key card gets demagnetized. That is again one of the major challenges lots of hotels are facing nowadays. Look at the third picture here. This is a power saver. Normally, whenever we insert an electronic key card into a power saver, it activates the electricity into the hotel's room. Now, there could be a possibility the moment you insert the card in, electricity trips in the room. That could be again termed as a major complaint, which engineering team need to work on that. Now, look at the next picture here. It shows that a couple is checking into a hotel. They are handing over the passports to the lady who's standing at the front desk, but it assumes that they do not have a room. There could be a possibility they need a room. There could be a possibility they have booked a room prior, but the lady is telling them, sorry, sir, we don't have rooms available. So as per any of the reason, it could be turned as a guest complaint. And again, all that reasons, it's only the supervisor or the manager, we should know how to handle a complaint. Now, all these complaints have been categorized into various parts here. And how do we discuss that? We can discuss them one by one here. Look at the first set of complaints here. The first one is a mechanical complaint. As you can see that in your picture, the first picture comprises of the thermostat which is there in a hotel's room. This is a thermostat where one can control a room's temperature. So there could be a possibility that thermostat doesn't work. It doesn't put you to a expected temperature of a room. Look at the second picture. There could be a possibility that lights doesn't work. There could be a malfunctioning of the lights. Third picture shows about the air condition does not have an adequate cooling as per someone's expectations. Fourth one again, LED doesn't work. So any of these complaints here, when they any of the things get faulty, we term them as mechanical complaints. Going further to second set of complaint, it's called attitudinal complaint. This set of complaint is basically when guest feels insulted by rude or maybe the tactless behavior of a hotel staff. They complain it, they approach it to a manager and they complain it, look boss, your staff is pretty rude. They don't know how to speak to a customer, get in touch with the customer. They don't know how to interact with the customer. These type of complaints, we term them as attitudinal complaints. Third one, pretty important. This is something which most of the hotels, entire industry I must say, is facing this issue. This is called a service related complaint. A complaint which is basically related to a service. You can look at the pictures here. The first one denotes that person ordered something but he got something else. Or maybe the food is not as per his expectations. The second one, someone did get a turn down service, which is majorly required by most of the customers during evening service. The third one, there could be a delay in coffee, tea and coffee service. That is also termed as a service related complaint. The fourth one, and why do we call them unusual complaint? These are basically complaints which normally are not usual. The hotel does not have a hold on it. So these are the complaints when customer turns up to you and says, boss, you do not have a play zone for kids. You do not have a helipad at hotel. You don't have a golf at a hotel. You have a swimming pool, but why it's not centrally heated? So these are the complaints which we term, why do we term as unusual? The hotel officials, the hotel employees can't do anything much about it. And they just need to record it. They need to inform it to their bosses. Because again, the bosses cannot do anything much about it. Because this is what the hotel was planned and built in a way. That thing was not planned earlier. That's why we call them unusual complaints. Now, these were the complaints which normally we have discussed about all the types of the complaint. But the important part is how one should handle a customer, someone who has approached it, how we can handle someone with a complaint. How can we provide and justify with the reason? Now, the important part is that one of us must understand that our industry is a service-oriented industry. The hotel staff always tries their level best to keep the customers happy. So we need to be ready with that answer, with that solution where we can sort of the customer, we can let the customers know we should make him or her happy so that they can keep on coming to the hotel again and again. Now, this has been described in a simple manner. You can look at the procedure here. It's called LEARN. LEARN is basically an abbreviation which normally teaches customer. So we'll do that one by one here. L stands for, I'll tell you in a simpler manner. Assume that a person approaches you with a complaint. What do we do? There is something which is being taught to us being an employee, being a manager is, we should always give our 100% and we should always and always listen to the customer first. Maybe the customer says, look boss, my AC doesn't work last night. There were bed bugs in my room. Your tea and coffee service was delayed. My luggage didn't reach up my room for at least half an hour when I checked into a hotel. So the important part being an employee is that we should always and always listen to that customer. What is he or she saying? That is something very important. Second important point is that we should always empathize with the customer. The meaning of empathize is that we should show some empathy towards our customer. Sir, I understand you. That is something which is very important. Customers should not feel neglected about it. Then the third one is when you have heard everything, we should always and always apologize to that customer. Sir, I understand. We really apologize for that. We will give our 100% to fix it. That is something which is very, very important. Then next step is our step where we need to react. The time for reaction. Now, how do we react here? Whatever the customer has brought you in complaint, it could be related to food, it could be related to bed bugs, it could be related to air conditioning. We need to request the customer that, sir, ma'am, please give us some time in order to fix it up. The moment someone leaves the room, we can request that person and we can, in the meanwhile, we can fix it up. We can inform the food and beverage manager, the executive housekeeper, or maybe the chief engineer to fix that up. And again, the moment that complaint has got resolved, you need to get it back to the customer saying that, sir, ma'am, you approached me in the morning, you told me about that concern. Being a manager, I've tried my level best and I have resolved that complaint. The meaning of notify is that you need to notify that customer. You need to approach that customer back. The customer should not feel that in the morning I spoke to someone at the front desk, I told him about that complaint, but no one has got back to me. No, it should not happen. You need to approach that customer back. Now, why this procedure is important, why we need to do all these things here. If you keep on doing all these things here, every industry person have just one motive. And that one motive is we should always and always exceed someone's expectations. And we need to keep on doing all that things to bring a smile on customer's face so that customer should again come back to us in the hotel. That is something which is very much important because all of us must understand that because there is something which is being taught to us initially also. There is something called word of mouth publicity. The moment someone leaves the hotel, that person will inform his nears and dears, his peers, his friends, his colleagues, look boss, I went to that hotel, the service was amazing. So publicity can be positive side, but publicity can be on the other side also. So the buck stands with us that how are we accepting that? How are we doing it? That is what which is very, very important. Thank you so much. I hope you like this. Thank you. Have a good day.